Yo, Fresh Air, tell me you saw it. It's all over the news. Breaking news, breaking news. Jesus is black. Oh! They said they had to tell it. There's something's about to be uncovered. Some huge fact that they couldn't keep the lie no more. And now they had to tell you the truth. Jesus is black. Oh! Whoa! How many people are still a Christian now? Oh, man. No wonder I lost my house. I should have known Jesus was black. No wonder I ain't rich. I should have known Jesus was black. No wonder I don't run the world. Jesus is black. Oh, man, all that money I done put in the church. No wonder I ain't got it back. Oh, man, no wonder all my kids are killing each other right now. Man, Jesus is black. That's why I'm eating pork and all this bullshit food, man. Now it makes sense. My car broke down. My family don't work. Now it all makes sense. Jesus is black. Oh, man, come on. If you realize that Jesus was actually black, which he was, would you still believe in Christianity the way that you actually believe? Well, let me help you out so you can help understand simple things. Egypt, Mount Sinai, Galilee, and every place named in the Bible, not one of those places in a European country. Not one of them. It's in the Middle East. In the Middle East of what? In the Middle East of Africa. First Solomon 5th verse. O ye women of Jerusalem, look not upon me, for I am black but comely. Translated, black but beautiful. Revelations 1:14. Hair of wool. Feet as a, not bronze. We know what bronze looks like. A penny. Burned bronze. So it's even darker than a penny. Now, every place, once again, Mount Sinai, Jerusalem, Galilee, every place you know, Corinthians, every place you know is in the Middle East of Africa.
Where Jesus' mama was from.
So do you still believe? And because he is black, does that make him not the Son of God? Does that now make him not God? Now is the Trinity tainted? Is it an Oreo now? Well, let's just look at all things and with common sense and reasoning. If black, to get the color black, you have to put every color in the spectrum together and press it. And then you get black. Now, if you got black and you put a drop of water on a science project, you get every color in the rainbow. You can only get white if you subtract all color. And then what remains is white. That's not saying that God's not there. God is even there, even in his absence of color. It's all God. So now, doesn't it actually make sense to you how you got green grass, blue skies, seas, yellow sun, brown trees, color, a drop in the darkness, and now everything is colored. You take that color away and you have a blank crayon piece of paper if you don't have no black outline. Your originator is black and it's not a crime. Your creator is black and it's not bad. Your brothers and sisters are still those Caucasoids that are Caucasians that are fighting for their lives, their understanding, and their theories. Regardless, they're still God's children. And if you consider them on the lower spectrum, then it is still your duty to take care of the least of them, which are God's children. So yeah, it's okay to be angry. It's okay to be mad. It's okay that you didn't live up to your expectations and now you understand who you are and you see this hole that you have to dig out of. That comes with the game of being daddy. That comes with the game of being mommy. Forgiving your children even when it's unforgivable circumstances. This is the part of being a child of God. Have fun, dance to some good music, and let's barbecue, players. We out of here. All right, all right. Oh! G-Soul! Yeah. News just in! All right, all right. Jesus is... Not only my president, but my resident. Oh, I see you, Truth. Dougie P. What if, oh, B-Boy Chili T. Yo, hey, what up, baby? G-Money, you know how we do, baby. DJ can't get right. Yes, sir. What they do, Naptown 317. What they say, ain't no love in my city. Them young boys got down, man. I'm about to find y'all. I'm bumping y'all shit. No doubt. Hey. Uh-huh. Yes, sir. I'm out.